This is a story that Australia could learn a lot from. By 2030, the UK plans to source one third of its electricity from this renewable resource.
Hi, I'm Martin Rice. I'm head of research for the Climate Council. I'm back in the UK where I'm originally from, and we're looking at offshore wind farms.
Here, off the coast of England, the wind farms are getting bigger and bigger and being built in deeper and deeper water. Technology is moving at a rapid pace and the costs of production are falling dramatically.
Offshore wind has been a really fabulous UK success story. It's been huge growth. We now have more offshore wind than anywhere else in the world.
Offshore wind is also helping to regenerate towns that were dying.
I think there's an increasing sense of something very, very special is happening.
Rob Walsh runs the local council at Grimsby, a port town that once boasted the world's largest fishing fleet. But those glory days are long gone. Things in Grimsby were grim until the advent of offshore wind.
The renewable energy boom has started. It is transformational, and Grimsby is front and centre in terms of that sector, which is amazing. It's almost a bit unbelievable, to be honest.
The Danish company Ørsted is building the world's largest offshore wind farm off the coast of Grimsby and has set up a maintenance hub in the town.
We've now got over 300 people that work from this facility. They're new jobs. They are good quality jobs which are going to be there for a long time.
The UK government says by 2030 there'll be 27,000 jobs in offshore wind.
What more could we want? Jobs, clean electricity. It's a real success story.
For years, both Labour and the Conservatives have been driving strong action on climate change, and they've backed the offshore wind industry by providing short-term subsidies. This political consensus sends a strong signal to investors.
We are, you know, developing our business around green energy, and that is the future.
Australia is one of the sunniest and windiest countries in the world. Imagine what we could do.